What up? It's your man, Big Brandon Carter. I'm out here in Rome, in front of the Colosseum, you know. As a modern day gladiator, it's only right that I come here and show love, man, show my respect. But anyway, I want to talk to y'all about who should not do intermittent fasting. You know, a lot of people, when they talk about intermittent fasting, they act like it's just a panacea for everything. You know, it's best for building muscle, best for losing fat, it fucking makes you dig hard, cures cancer, all types of shit. It's not, you know, it's not a panacea. It's not for everyone. It's not optimal for everyone. And everything's not for everyone. And, you know, like, it's going to be good for some people in some circumstances, and it's going to be not ideal for other people in other circumstances. Here's a few circumstances I think are not optimal for intermittent fasting. One would be if you're trying to put on muscle and you're just a skinny guy naturally or skinny woman naturally, and you're trying to put on muscle, I don't think intermittent fasting is going to be optimal for you. Here's the thing. I do intermittent fasting when I'm bulking. I think I have a video on it. You know, I just get my surplus, all my calories during the feeding window. That's probably the best way that I know to stay ripped while you're putting on muscle, like to gain as little fat as possible. That's probably the most effective method. But putting on the muscle is slower. It's slower than if you were just eating around the clock. And that's because when you're eating around the clock and you get a constant supply of protein and amino acids, you're going to be in higher protein synthesis, meaning you're just going to put on muscle faster, your muscle is going to repair faster and grow quicker. If you're restricting your protein synthesis to 8 hours, it's going to be slower. If you're getting protein around the clock, then you're going to put on muscle faster. So if staying lean is not a problem for you, and you just want to put on as much muscle as soon as possible, then I would say that intermittent fasting is probably not ideal under those circumstances. It's good to bulk with intermittent fasting if staying lean when bulking is a problem for you, right? If you're one of those guys who just gets fat every time he bulks, then this is your best bet. In fact, when I was younger, I was just real skinny, and I had a hard time putting on any muscle at all, and I get made crazy gains when I woke up in the middle of the night. I set alarm, woke up in the middle of the night and had like a protein shake, you know. So I had one before I went to sleep, then woke up, had one in the middle of the night, and then had another one as soon as I woke up. So I was getting protein 24 hours a day, and that just made me a lot. I got bigger way quicker, you know. So protein synthesis around the clock, you're gonna put on muscle faster. But if you have a problem staying lean, you might want to try intermittent fasting bulking. If you don't have a problem staying lean, then just eat round the clock, man. Fuck bulking on intermittent fasting. When I was younger, I just ate round the clock. Like I said, I woke up even in the middle of the night to get some protein. But as now, I'm in my 30s now, so my metabolism's not the same. I'm older, you know. A lot of guys in their 30s, they start getting the gut. I ain't fucking with that. So I still like to bulk on intermittent fasting. It's slower. The putting on muscle is slower. I shit you not, putting on muscle is slower, but you will stay leaner. But if staying lean is not a problem for you, just bulk. The second circumstances that are not ideal for intermittent fasting is someone who wants to exceed in any sport or athletic endeavor, right? Like if training for athletics and training for aesthetics are two totally different things, two totally different protocols. Like I've trained some guys in the NFL, professional athletes, and we didn't give a fuck about how they looked. You know what I'm saying? Like it was all about performance. It was all about performance. So there's no way I would have them on an intermittent fasting protocol. We want them to get stronger quick, recover quick, so they can, you know, train again, train harder again sooner. So we weren't restricting their fucking calories or protein to an 8-hour feeding window. We had them eating a fucking ton of food all the time, especially because we were training like 2-3 times a day. So all that cardio, all the weightlifting, you know, they needed like a constant supply of calories, you know, and we weren't doing cardio to get ripped either. We were doing cardio so they can win games, right? Because training for aesthetics and training for athletics are two totally different things. In fact, I think if you're serious about a sport, it's not even good to be extra lean. Unless it's track athletes usually get pretty lean because their job is hit cardio. But guys in the field, they don't be like 1% body fat, you know. They don't be like in the single digits body fat. You know, we keep them I mean, they're lean, especially by like normal person standards, but they're not lean by bodybuilding standards. And that's good, you know, like that's good. We don't give a fuck about that. We care about performance. So performance, you're gonna have better performance if you're getting a consistent supply of calories and a consistent supply of protein, you know. So don't, I get questions all the time, how do I do an intermittent fasting if I play this sport? Don't, man, what the fuck? Your sport should be more, unless you're not serious about the sport, you know, you're more concerned about your body, the way you look, than your sport, right? This is why CrossFit gyms don't have mirrors, because it's not supposed to be about your look, it's supposed to be about your performance. So like no CrossFit gym has mirrors, at least they're not supposed to. If you see a CrossFit gym with a mirror, they're risking getting their franchise revoked, or you know, they're lying about being a CrossFit gym. They're not really a franchise, they're just using the name illegally, right? Because when it's about performance, you shouldn't give a fuck how you look. Finally, another circumstance where intermittent fasting is not ideal is if you just don't want to do this shit. Like, you don't have to. People were getting ripped when everybody ate six meals a day. People still got ripped. A lot of people got ripped. Like, you don't need to do it. It's just a tool. Some people act like, you got to do it, man. If you ain't doing intermittent fasting, you ain't shit. You know, oh, it's the best way. It's the best. It's the best ever. It might be the best for you for what you're doing, but it's not going to be the best for everyone all the time. You know, sometimes you just don't want to fucking do this shit, man. And that's cool. That's cool. It's like, the reason some people become ideologues about this shit is because, you know, if all you have is a hammer, then every problem looks like a nail. But to build a house, you need more than a hammer. You need fucking all types of tools, right? So it's one tool to have in your tool belt. Don't act like it's going to be the shit. It's not the end all be all to bodybuilding or aesthetic success, right? It's one of the tools, man. You can have your tool belt. You know, you may never pull it out, but it's good to know about it. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people take a hybrid approach. They do a more traditional bulk, just eating around the clock, and then they just cut on intermittent fasting. Some people I know do the opposite. You know, it's just whatever, man. You got to find what works for you. It's just a tool for your tool belt, man. All right? If you want to know more about intermittent fasting, I wrote a book all about it. Link in the description. It's 100% free. So fuck with it. Peace.